Program is Business They Short It. Today we will be looking at an important issue, which is budget and deficit financing. I am Chinua Lilianamadi, and with me is our in-house analyst, another one actually. His name is Mr. Dozie Ifebi. How are you, Mr. Dozie?
Fine, thanks for inviting me to the show.
Please, can you give us a general overview of the federal budget and debt position of the government?
Okay, looking at last year's budget and comparing it to this year's budget, we see that this year's budget has actually been reduced from last year's levels. 2014 budget stood at 4.6 trillion, and then this year's budget currently stands at 4.46 trillion. So actually, we can see a reduction in the federal budget. Also, going alongside that, attendance to the fall in oil prices, we saw that capital expenditure was actually dropped to 15% of the total budget, while current expenditure now stands at 85%. Currently, as of last year's figures, we noticed debt to GDP ratio is around 13%, and we expect this to rise over the course of this year following the increased borrowing of the government.
Okay, so how has the fall in oil prices affected government borrowing? How has it affected?
It has affected government borrowing very significantly because initially the government proposed a budget benchmark of $65, and they have been called by analysts to reduce this budget to reflect the new realities. Also, going with the inconsistent oil production output, we see that the break-even price for the government is actually higher than $100 a barrel, and with production targets not being too realistic or not being achievable, this might be a problem.
Okay, so what are the current debt levels of the government, and where do you see this going?
As of last year, the end of last year, total government debt was debt service was around 712 billion. This was in comparison to the budget of last year. Last year's budget was 4.6 trillion. So we saw debt service to GDP ratio of 15.5%. Now debt service has actually increased to 750 billion compared to the budget of 4.4 trillion. So we see this ratio, debt service to GDP ratio, at around 16.8%. So we can see that marginal increase. So last year's debt to GDP ratio was at 13%. So following the new realities, we expect this to rise over the course of the year.
Okay, so what's the outlook on government borrowing? Do you see changes significantly?
Yes, of course. So like I said before, we expect borrowing to increase because government can't meet it. We will not be able to meet its revenue targets. Also, the oil scenario is still very much uncertain. We've seen some slight rebounds, but those are more the result of temporal factors, not permanent factors. We've seen a structural shift in the oil landscape, so the government will still have to make changes to buffer up its revenue sources, so to speak.
Okay, so what impact would increased federal government borrowing have on the economy and on asset classes like the equities, the subnational bonds, and...
Yeah, definitely this is going to have both positive and negative impacts. Some of the negative impacts on me and on the specified asset classes. So first of all, we're dealing with the crowding out of private investments, where investment managers, asset managers would be looking to pack more of their funds in government securities because of the increased yields. Government yields have actually increased this period. We're looking at yields of between 14 and 15%. So this is definitely more attractive than previously, and it's going to appeal to investors, especially in the light of volatility in the stock markets. So in terms of equities, you're going to see more withdrawal of funds from stocks and into government securities. And we're going to see withdrawal of investment funds from subnational bonds and from corporate bonds, all in favor of government securities. But it also has positive impacts as well, and some of the positive impacts will include improved foreign exchange inflows on the back of the higher yields. Broadly speaking, a lot of investment managers in other economies, other developed economies, will be looking for higher yields, and as such, they will naturally flock around government securities. So that is a positive for us.
Okay, so do you think domestic debt services would be a problem the next few years? Okay, and if so, What do you suggest the government should do?
Yeah, it's definitely going to be a problem because debt service to GDP to budget last year, 2014, was around 15%. Now it has shot up to about 16.8%, so we've seen a slight increase. And going forward, with the whole scenario being uncertain, we expect this to increase further. We'll be looking at debt service to GDP of about 17%, close to 18% this year. And this is not good. It's going to be more stress on government, and generally it's a negative picture. And about what government should do, I think this is going to be a good time for government to be more aggressive in terms of diversifying its revenue heads, most especially the non-oil sector. So government should look more into raising, improving the internal generated revenue of some of the states, like VAT taxes, not simply taxes, which it has already done, and trying to prop up some of the key segments of the oil sector.
Thank you, Mr. Dozie, for coming by. It's still Business Day Short Takes. I am Amadi Chinelilia. Thank you.